So this happened to me on my very, very first time. I use actually any type of watercolors. And I don't know how they behave. I don't know anything. So I just intend to do the best of my abilities. Oh wait, I did one quick thing which you can see on the website. I added a little bit of water on the face. So I noticed a little bit of the reaction. So the point right now is how many shades do I have to do, how many layers of, and what comes first. So I added, as I have seen, the yellow, brown and orange shades, which are actually different, of course, in the picture. In the picture they are like little dots, but you can see actually the independent colors in the original, which I'm unable to do with this medium. And then there is on this on the left side, I mean on her right side, on the left side of the drawing, the painting, there is darker gray shades on top. So I wondered, do I wish to put the gray on top of the colors? Does it go now or later? Right now I wish I would have done it later, but that's what I did. And now you can see what happened as we continue. I am not nervous, I'm overwhelmed to fit everything in the small space. So this is laying next to or handed by my bottle. Where earlier the water went, now I have to find a different way. Here's where the phone goes, where I can actually watch the picture. And here are the colors, and here's the water, safe to the left, so I will not accidentally do anything with a little bit of water in it. This I have to kind of move to achieve all the colors in this swatch. So now I'm gonna apply water, and which I would love to show you, see if I can. It makes me nervous, this is really difficult. Now I did tab the water a little bit on the paper, because I don't know how it's reacting. So it's fine now. I'm gonna start off, I don't know, maybe here. I wish I had better light. Okay, so if I don't move much, it stays. Oops, sorry. All right. The thing is, as I do this, I need to watch the picture. Because now it's really hard for me to do that. Circling around the glass with the phone on the hand, because I have to hold it to the lips. Okay, let's see, a little bit, it's light. Oh, sorry, what am I doing? Okay, so no, I will do this. So. And I remember that up here. We have a little bit red up. Oh, I feel it's too much. I'm sorry if I'm disturbing. No, I did actually clean the pencil out more. I'm sorry, the brush. I'm sorry about the words. Now, if I just lightly tap it. That's the whole thing. I don't really know anything about this. Okay. There's no space to put the phone in a holder. It's way too yellow right now, I think. But then again, maybe I have to go with more layers. So what I'm intending to do right now is just activate the color. I wasn't sure whether to put the gray shades on top or not yet. I wasn't sure about that at all. And then there's the situation with the picking up the gray from the graphic. It looks dirty right now, if you ask me. Well, there's still color in it. Now the right side is completely light, and so maybe I need more water. No, I don't do anything, I just take it out of here. I'm sorry if I'm looking at my phone around. Which is, oh, I can clearly see it, there must be more gray. Of course, now I can make choices. Do I want to maybe exactly as I see in the photo? Or am I gonna be able and willing to actually go with what I see here and what my sense of freedom allows me to do one more thing. No, intuitively I shouldn't do too many brush strokes, if you ask me. It's exactly the same color, but on one side it's more saturated and in part partially darker. No, I didn't separate any. If I'm arguing now, I was just about to tell the lady, because you know, because they're all like the same, that I kind of wish them to slow down. There you go, there is a part, but I don't know, maybe I didn't want to put the gray color on because it sounds a little bit dirty. But it's like a shade, but it's a start. And now I wish to add more orange on that side, as I have been seeing. And look at the exact contour of the lips, which is, you know, it's dark on the side, darker than in the middle. She's not wearing lipstick. See, I'm telling you, this is like unpredictable. Now what I can do is I can take out a little bit of this shade from here. I also know it needs more shade and put it over here. But intuitively, I think I shouldn't do more brush strokes on top. I don't think that makes any difference. I added a little bit of color in here. Sorry, I moved the phone. And here's the situation. How am I gonna do this so it takes the color? Now, I do know that we have, I haven't done anything, because the hair is pretty much the same color as well, and different things. I don't know, I'm intending to see if I have more color. Now, of course, I could go on and on right now without looking at the picture or not. This has to be a little darker, but I also feel it has to be more orange. I know that the lips are darker, the brighter in the original. This is probably something I invented here. It's very light, the red shades here and there and there and there. And on and on, and what I'm actually doing right now, I'm learning how to see how these colors react. It's also like, it looks like she's got uneven skin. I think it's easier to make it with more water and less strokes, or I don't really know what I'm commenting on. So here you go, I'm gonna look at the picture and see what else I can do. Now if I had to do it as we speak, I had to find the color, which could be 115. Let's see. Continue to hold it. And I'm lazy, I wanna take the other color. It could also be 113. How does this even work? I don't really know. Okay, I'm gonna just push a little bit of color right there. It's wet now. I'm leaving it pretty wet and see what it does to me. No, I feel it's too wet. See, this is not what I had been doing earlier. Now, since I'm on it, see, this is not how I feel. It's right. There is no way to be frustrated or intentionally about this, because we're just learning. We can be faster. I mean, I don't know. So now this doesn't work out. Now the paper is falling apart. So now I wish I would have done that much lighter. Now here's the point. What I could do now. Right now I start to feel excited because I think this is artsy. It's almost like, I don't know. It's not comic. It's not But you know, comic figures, what we see that they have like this splash and whoosh expressions, and I think this is a very cool expression. But if I don't do it right, like in the photo, you're gonna tell me I don't know how to do it. If that's the purpose. I don't know. I really don't know. No, it doesn't look long enough because I haven't developed the hair yet, which adds to the picture. And of course, if you want me to, I can do this now. Okay, next time I'm gonna find a way. Now what I do know is that this here is the same colors. I'm just gonna take a little bit of a darker shade right now, and I apply it lightly. Okay, more color here. Yeah, enough. And now I'm focusing a lot on my swatch, so I'm just grabbing random pencils because that's fun to do. Now what I do now is that he is dark and gray. And let's say I'm gonna skip this for now. I'm gonna do different than I had done earlier. Okay, now since I would like to use the darker color, also on the right side lighter, I'm just gonna use a lot of water. I think it's a lot of water. There you go. And now I'm gonna smush it to the other side, getting it all out of my brush. See, I don't really know how long the neck is. And if I had to do dark, I don't know if I have to wait. But right now it feels to me like as I have to work really quick and I wish I had something to put my brush down. A dark gray color, which could be anyone. I'm starting to improvise. How about this one? Get to know your colors. Now I just had that in my mouth. Now how about, oh shit, that's fancy. Sorry. How about I put dark color right here? Because I know I don't have to smash it. And let's see if I grab a little bit here and start putting it in the side. I don't know. I don't think, see, can I take it out of there? And then again, what kind of paper am I using? I don't think it's a really good paper for this. I mean, it's not exactly bad or wrong, but I don't remember that there's such a big line. So I need more darker. I really want me to do this live now. Well, I would feel frustrated if I expected it to be done right away. My pencil is not fair. I'm sorry, my pencil just fell down. See, it looks easy, right, when you see someone who has experience in this. Because the paper is falling apart right now. I need more. Shit, now everything fell down. I think I have to stop my video. Now I'm not allowed to, I'm forced to look at that. So just hang in with me for a moment. Now this doesn't make much sense. Because it's already so thick and that's really not how the layer, I'm sorry. This is not how the layer lays. I will just maybe dry it and then put lighter strokes on top. Like what's depicted, how it works before. This has to go in there, but this wants to. Again, I'll start to feel filthy. But if I continue developing the shade, then probably it's gonna be nice. How do I feel about it? Light and shade, at least more different colors on this side, I feel. That's how I feel about it. No, the original has like, it has a shade of yellow and then a shade of like orange, like in little points and little dots, one on top of the other. And then on this side, shades of gray. Let's pause for a moment, how about that?
Watercolor soap is a little bit zen-like, like a powerful way to enlightenment, because since you have to kind of accept what's happening, allow what happened, and that's it. I mean, of course, whatever else happens, you can do it, but acceptance and allowance is pretty powerful. Just go with it.